Hello friends, welcome back to our channel NEET Biology Expert. I am Dr. Parveen. In this lecture series, we are studying Class 12 Biology Molecular Basis of Inheritance chapter. In this particular lesson, we are going to learn about transforming principle. When DNA and its structure was discovered, many scientists, they tried hard to prove that DNA is the genetic material. Actually, there was a search for the genetic material. Many scientists, they had a thought that proteins are the genetic material, not DNA. Whereas several experiments were done to prove DNA is the genetic material. So three important experiments are there. Griffith experiment, which was done in the year 1928. Avery, MacLeod and McCarthy experiment, which was done in the year 1944. And Hershey and Chase experiment in the year 1952. So out of these three, Hershey and Chase experiment finally proved that DNA is the genetic material. For that, Avery, MacLeod, McCarthy experiment and Griffith experiment paid the backbone. Okay. So in this lecture, we will study these two experiments. Okay. So let's first start with Griffith experiment. In the year 1928, the year is very, very important in all these lectures. Okay. So in the year 1928, a British medical officer called Frederick Griffith. So this gentleman, he was trying to study about a bacteria which is called as Streptococcus pneumoniae. Streptococcus pneumoniae is a bacteria which causes a disease called pneumonia. It causes pneumonia in human beings and also in mammals. So it was a major cause of death during his period of time. So he wanted to study about this bacteria in detail, how it causes the diseases, all such things. Okay, right. So look here, this is the bacteria Streptococcus pneumoniae, which is also called as pneumococcus. When we see the structure of this bacteria, this is a round shaped bacteria. So that's why this is called as coccus. That too, this round shaped bacteria, they are arranged in a chain like structure. Okay, in a chain like pattern. So chain means a strepto. Hence, the name for this bacteria is called Streptococcus, round-shaped cocci which are arranged in chain. That's why it's called as Streptococcus. So, since it causes a disease called pneumonia, the species name is given as pneumoniae. Okay. So, this is the bacteria, how it looks, Streptococcus pneumoniae. This is a gram-positive bacteria. Gram-positive means this is a staining method. For bacteria, we could not able to see because they are transparent structures. So in order to see the structures of the bacteria under microscope, we need to give them color. That is what we call as a staining. So gram staining is the important staining which we give bacteria to observe them under microscope. So these bacteria take gram positive color, which is purple or violet in color. So that's why it appears purple or violet under microscope. Okay, understand? Right. So this Streptococcus pneumoniae is an airborne infection. That means when the bacteria enters through nasal tract, okay, so it enters directly into the lungs and it causes infection in the lung, which leads to pneumonia. So pneumonia is the problem caused by Streptococcus pneumoniae, which Griffith was studying about. Okay, so before moving on to Griffith's experiment, we have to learn some terminologies which we will come across in this lecture throughout. Okay, so the first one is strain. What is a strain? Strain is a genetic variant or a subtype of a microorganism. Each microorganism will have a strain. Whether it will be a bacteria or virus or fungi, it will have a strain. That means a subtype. The type will be at the molecular level, at the genetic level. For example, if we talk about coronavirus, initially we just called it as coronavirus. Now we call it as alpha virus, beta virus, delta virus, omicron. So what are all these? These are the subtypes of corona. That is variants, which we call biologically as a strain. Okay, so strain is a genetic variant or the subtype of an organism. The second terminology is virulence. What is virulence? Virulence is the ability of an organism to infect the host and cause disease. It is the organism, the microorganism contains something which gives the bacteria or the virus the disease causing capability or capacity. That property is called virulence. For example, some bacteria, cell wall is the virulent factor. For bacteria, some bacteria, take for example, typhoid causing bacteria, the typhoid toxin is the virulent factor. Okay, some particular thing will be present in that bacteria which cause the disease. So that is the virulence factor. And the third terminology is pathogenic. Pathogen means any disease causing agent is called pathogen. So the disease causing capacity of an organism is called as pathogenicity. Okay. So in order to be pathogenic, an organism should be virulent. You understand? So these are some important terminologies we have to know. Right. So let's move on to the Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria, what Griffith was working on. This bacteria exists in two different forms. Okay. So when you grow a Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria in a laboratory, generally we use culture, right? So culture means the food for the bacteria where we grow the bacteria in the laboratory. So this is a blood agar plate. So when we grow this bacteria, we could able to see two different forms of the bacteria. Okay. So see, this is the colonies of the bacteria. So colonies means these are the growth where millions of bacterial cells will be present in one colony. Okay. So the Streptococcus pneumoniae produces two different types of colony. The first type is called as a smooth type of colonies. Smooth type of colonies. Why this is called smooth type of colonies? Because when you look at this in a zoom view, okay, it will be like this. Okay. Look here, each colony is having some glittery or shiny or jelly-like appearance. So such colonies are called as smooth colonies. Whereas another type of Streptococcus pneumoniae, they produce rough type colonies. When we see this in a close-up view, it will be like this. It produces flat, rough type colonies. These are the two types of Streptococcus pneumoniae. Okay. So whichever bacteria produces a smooth colonies, those are called as S strain or S type. S strain or S type. Okay. Whichever produces rough colonies, those bacteria are called as R strains or R type. So Streptococcus pneumoniae produces two different types of colonies because two different types exist in that. Okay. So why this variation is there? Why there are two different types? Because for some bacteria, outside its cell wall, it has another layer that is what called as capsule. Look at this picture. This purple color thing is a Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria. So surrounding the cell wall, there is an another extra protective covering for this bacteria, which is actually a capsule. This capsule is a polysaccharide capsule. It is made up of polysaccharides. Okay. So since this polysaccharide capsules are present, those bacteria produces a smooth type of colonies on the agar plate. Since some bacteria do not have polysaccharide capsules surrounding its cell wall, they produces rough type of colonies on the agar plate. Understood? Okay. Why this capsule is essential for the bacteria? Because this is a virulence factor for the bacteria. Virulence factor means, I told you, when the organism invades a host, when it enters inside the host, it has to escape from the host immunity, isn't it? So in order to multiply inside your host and cause a disease, first the microorganism should escape from the host immune system. So one of the escaping mechanism is by producing capsules. So what happened? This capsules, which is present surrounding the bacterial cell wall, it gives an extra protective covering. So as a result, it escapes from phagocytosis. Phagocytosis, which is a process of immune cells. Some type of immune cells called phagocytes. It's a type of WBC cell. So any new disease-causing organism or any foreign pathogen or foreign agent comes inside our body, these phagocytes go and just they eat up all this foreign material. So it helps our body to get free from infection. Okay. So this is called phagocytosis. So in order to escape from that phagocytosis mechanism, this bacteria is having an extra protective covering. So what do you understand from here? Any bacteria which is having capsule surrounding its cell wall will be pathogenic. Understand? It's because capsule is a virulence factor. It helps the bacteria to act as a pathogen. So ultimately, in the Streptococcus pneumoniae, all the smooth strains, the S strains bacteria, they are pathogenic or they are virulent, in other words. Okay. All the rough strains bacteria, rough strains means they don't have outside capsule. So they produce rough colonies. As a result, they are non-virulent. They are non-pathogenic. Pathogenic means this type of bacteria will not cause disease in any organism, whereas smooth strain of bacteria cause disease. Understood, right? So here in this rough and smooth, there are different subtypes. So which we call as R1, R2, R3. Okay, these are the subtypes with minor genetic variations. And in the smooth strain also, there is subtypes S1, S2, S3. Okay, just you learned this. Okay, not much important. So these are the subtypes present in this organism. Okay, now what Griffith did, when he chose this Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria for his experiment, he took two different strains, right? So the first strain is a smooth strain. Smooth strain, that means the bacteria has capsule surrounding its cell wall. It produces smooth colonies on the agar plate. On that also, he chose S3 type of bacteria. Understand? Then he took another type of Streptococcus, that is a rough type. Okay. So that we will be representing as like this. This means rough type of colonies, rough colonies. Okay. So in this, he chose R2 because there are three types, isn't it? So he chose R2. So S3 and R2, these are the two strains of bacteria Griffith took for his experiments. Okay. So when we look at the characters or the properties of these strains, where the S3 type is having capsule, right? So that is what we call as encapsulated. It is having a capsule. So as a result, it produces a smooth type of colonies on the agar plate. So since it is having capsule, it is virulent. So as a result, it causes disease. It is pathogenic. All the S strain of bacteria cause disease, pathogenic. Whereas this R type is just opposite to this. R strain is non-capsulated. It is not having any capsule. It produces rough colonies on the agar plate. Since there is no capsule, it is non-virulent or avirulent. So since the virulency is not there, it is non-pathogenic. It will not cause any disease in the organisms. Understood? So these are the two strains of the bacteria which Griffith took for his experiments. So let us move on to Griffith's experiment. Griffith, he did four experiments consecutively. The first experiment was, he took a rough strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae. What is rough strain? It is non-virulent. It will not cause any disease, right? So this rough strain of bacteria, he took pure form of this bacteria. He injected this bacteria into a mouse and observed that the mouse did not have any infection. It is alive. This was his first experiment. Then he took the second experiment where smooth strain, that is the virulent form of the bacteria, was taken. Okay, this is the smooth strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae. Similarly, he injected this into a mouse and observed that the mouse had disease. It developed disease and it dies. This was his second experiment. Then in the third experiment, what he did was, he took the smooth strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae, that means the same virulent strain, whereas he did a small change. He just heated the bacterial sample. That means he took the smooth virulent strain of the bacteria in test tube and just heated this. Okay. So when the heat is given, what will happen? All the bacteria gets killed. Okay. So this is what now used for the experiment. This is what we call heat killed smooth strain of bacteria. This is his third experiment. Okay. Heat killed smooth strain of the Streptococcus pneumoniae was taken. Then he injected this sample into mouse again. When he observed, he found that the mouse did not develop any infection. It was alive. Okay. Though the bacteria was a smooth virulent strain, since it was heated, it killed all the organisms. As a result, the mouse was alive. Okay. This was the third experiment. Then in the fourth experiment, he did a small change. That is, in a test tube, what he did was, he took the heat killed smooth strain of bacteria and mixed this with the rough non-virulent strain of Streptococcus. Understand? These two samples were mixed in this. Okay. And he incubated this for some time. What is incubation? Incubation means, see, our body temperature is 37 degrees. So in this body temperature only, all the microorganisms grows well. So in order to have a same temperature in the laboratory environment, we have a special instrument called incubator. In that incubator, the temperature will be 37. So any experiments, if you want to conduct, we have to keep our cortical flask or test tube in that 37 degree, and then we will check out all the results. Okay. So similarly, he kept his test sample which contained rough strain and he killed smooth strain. Okay, this sample in the incubator 37 degree, and after 4 to 5 hours later, he injected those sample into another mouse. When he observed, he found that the mouse was dead. Okay, it is having some infection. It got some infection. Okay, so this result really surprised Griffith. Why? Because though he used heat killed smooth virulent strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae, the mouse was dead. Isn't it? How it happened? Because in the test tube, this is a heat killed bacteria. The another set of bacteria was a rough strain, which is not a pathogen, which is not causing any disease. Then how this mouse had infection, how it got killed. So this result actually surprised Griffith. Okay. So when you see in your textbook, NCERT book, this experiment is actually given like this, where the first experiment, that is R strain of bacteria, when injected into the mice was alive. When the S strain of the bacteria was injected into the mice was dead. When the S strain was heat killed and then injected into the mice was alive. In the fourth experiment, when the heat killed S strain was mixed with live R strain, then injected into the mice died. Okay, so these are the four experiments we did. And the very interesting thing he found was, in his fourth experiment, where this from the dead mouse, he did autopsy. What is autopsy? After any organism is dead, we take the tissue from the organism and find out the reason for the death. Okay, that is called autopsy. So in the autopsy, from the tissue of this mouse, he isolated smooth strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria. This result was really shocking and interesting for him. Why? Because when what he injected in this particular mouse, he injected smooth killed strain and non-virulent rough strain. Whereas from the dead mouse, he isolated smooth virulent strain. This variety of bacteria only he isolated. Okay. So this result was surprising to him. So when he wrote his experiment results, he told that, he suggested that the heat killed S strain bacterium had somehow changed the live R strain bacterium into S strain bacterium. Okay. See, the heat killed bacteria somehow changed this rough strain bacteria into a smooth strain bacteria. So that smooth strain bacteria only caused disease in this mouse. He could not exactly able to say what was that, how it happened. So he concluded his experiments that something got transformed from this heat kill smooth strain into the rough strain, that he called as transforming principle. Transforming principle. So the transforming principle got transferred and it enabled the rough strain to synthesize the polysaccharide capsule around itself so that the rough strain become smooth strain. Okay. He had an idea that that transforming material is definitely a genetic material, but he don't have any proof to show that whether this genetic material is DNA or RNA or could be protein also. He could not have any proof to show that. Okay. So ultimately, after the Griffith experiment, he could not able to define what is the biochemical nature of this genetic material. What was that genetic material? How this transforming principle worked? What is that transforming principle exactly, which convert this transformation from the rough strain into smooth strain? Such thing he could not able to explain from his results. Understood? See, this is the Griffith's experiment transforming principle. So when he took the heat killed smooth strain, which actually a virulent bacteria, okay, since it is virulent also, when it is heat killed, it will lose all its virulency, isn't it? So now here it is a non-virulent, isn't it? So when this bacteria was mixed with a rough strain of the bacteria, which is avirulent, what happened? Something happened inside that test tube, which made this rough strain bacteria to convert into a smooth strain bacteria. That means surrounding the rough strain bacteria, a new capsule is now produced. Okay, how it is produced? Because from this capsulated bacteria, something was transferred to this, which made this to transform into a smooth strain. This is what he called as transforming principle, but he could not able to conclude what was that transforming principle. Understood? Then, later, after 16 years, Griffith did his experiment. Three scientists, they tried to prove what was that. So this is what we call biochemical characterization of transforming principle. Three scientists from New York City called Oswald Avery, McLean McCarthy, and Colin McLeod. These three scientists, they worked together as a group. Okay. So they wanted to determine what was that biochemical nature of the transforming principle responsible for converting the Griffith's non-virulent strain into virulent strain. So what was that exactly happened during Griffith experiment? So in order to identify this, they repeated this Griffith experiment. Okay, they repeated Griffith experiment in vitro. What is in vitro? If we do any experiment inside a living cell, that is called in vivo. If we do any experiment in a laboratory condition, in a test tube, in a conical flask, that is called in vitro experiment. Okay. So they did this experiment in the year 1944. Again, the year is very, very important. Okay. So every McLeod McCartney experiment was done in the year 1944. Right. So let's move on to what exactly they did. Just observe this, very much easy to understand. So first they took live smooth strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae, same like what Griffith did. Initially they took this thing. Okay. Then this live smooth strain of the bacteria was heated. What will happen? All the bacteria will be killed. So this is what we now call as heat killed smooth strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae. Now this bacteria lose its virulence. They took this heat killed bacterial sample in a test tube and they removed all the biochemical molecules from this bacteria, leaving only proteins, DNA and RNA. Okay, that means they removed all the lipids, all the sugars and other biochemical molecules. Only protein, DNA and RNA were removed. Why? Because they wanted to see which one exactly acted as a transforming principle, whether it was a protein, DNA and RNA. Okay, so in order to study that, they left only these three molecules and all the rest other molecules were removed. Okay, then they separated this bacterial sample into three groups. Okay. So in the first group, what they did, they treated the sample with an enzyme called protease. Protease is an enzyme which will degrade all the proteins, isn't it? So anything which ends with ASE is called enzyme. So they added protein degrading enzyme, that is protease, to that test tube. So as a result, all the proteins in this test tube, in this bacterial sample, got degraded. So what is remaining here? Only DNA and RNA is remaining, isn't it? Now what they did, they took this sample which contains only DNA and RNA and mixed that sample with live rough strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae, as how Griffith did, isn't it? He mixed the smooth heat kill strain with rough strain. Similarly, they are doing here. They removed all the proteins from this sample. Only DNA and RNA is left out. To that sample, they are adding now the rough A virulent strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae. This sample was incubated, then injected into a mouse. They observed that the mouse is alive. That means it did not get any infection. Okay, so this showed that the protein is not the transforming principle in the Griffith experiment. So no change was noticed here. The mice is alive. No change was noticed, no infection occurred here. So the protein is not the transforming principle. So the protein got eliminated from the list. Okay, understood. Now, they did the second experiment where from the same culture, okay, they took another test tube. Now they are adding the enzyme to destroy RNA only. That is called RNAs. RNAs are the enzymes which degrade only RNA. So to this test tube, second test tube, they are adding only RNAs which will destroy all the RNAs. So no RNA will be left out in the culture tube. So what will be there? It will have proteins and it will have DNA, isn't it? Proteins and DNA will be present. Then to this test tube, again they are adding rough strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae, incubating this for 4 to 5 hours, then injecting this sample into another mouse. Observe that this mouse is also alive. That means no disease developed in this mouse. This shows that the RNA is not the genetic material. It is not the transforming principle. Understood? Okay. So because all the RNA got degraded, there is nothing, no RNA here. So if the RNA is here, what would have happened? The mouse have been dead, isn't it? It not happened like that. So in the second experiment, the RNA was ruled out. So from the first experiment, protein was ruled out. Second experiment, RNA was ruled out. Then what is remaining? Only DNA. So in order to prove that, they are doing again the third experiment, where now they are treating the bacterial cells with an enzyme to destroy only DNA. They are treating the bacterial cells with DNase enzyme. So the DNase is the enzyme which degrade only DNA. Okay. So in this test tube, what will be happening? In this test tube, all the DNA will be degraded. So what will be present now? Only RNA and proteins will be present. RNA and proteins will be present. Now again, to this sample, they mix a rough strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae, incubating this, and then again injecting this sample into mouse. After some period, they found that the mouse had infection. It died. Okay. Also, similarly, how Griffith did. He did autopsy sample from the dead mouse and checked for what type of bacteria present, isn't it? So similarly, these three scientists were also doing. So when they checked from this dead mouse, they isolated live, yes, smooth strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae. So the result what Griffith, they got here when they treat the sample with DNase. Okay. So they now had a proof that, so DNA is the transforming principle. You may ask me like, ma'am, when the DNA is all degraded, then how the DNA will act as a transforming principle? Because when you see in the genetics, let me show you here, there is something called a transformation. Transformation is a process by which the bacteria takes up the DNA from the environment. There are three ways in which genetic material get transferred from one bacteria to another. The first one is called conjugation. Conjugation means that direct mating between two bacteria. If one bacteria is there, if it contains a DNA, okay, it will give its DNA to another bacteria through direct mating between them, through sex spiling. So this method, direct cell-to-cell contact and transformation, is called conjugation. Another method is there where from a bacterial cell, a specific virus called bacteriophage. This is the bacteriophage virus, which is a virus which particularly kills bacteria. Virus eating bacteria are called bacteriophage. So this bacteriophage virus, when it, after it enters inside a cell, bacterial cell, destroy it. While it is coming out, it will take up the genetic material of this bacteria and transform this genetic material into another bacteria, new bacteria, when it is infecting that. Okay. So transfer of the genetic material between bacteria through viruses is called transduction. This is another method. Okay. The third and the most common method is called transformation. Transformation means when a bacterial cell is dead, what will happen? See here, look at this picture here. Here, this is a bacterial cell. So when this bacterial cell is dead, ruptured and it is dead. Okay. So all the genetic material will be present surrounding the bacteria in the environment. So any other bacteria of the same type, same species, when it comes closer to this dead bacteria, it will take up these genetic material directly by absorption. Okay. And it inserts this genetic material into its DNA. So this bacteria gets a new genetic material now. So this method, direct transformation of the genetic material from one bacteria, which is dead, into another bacteria, is called transformation. So this transformation was exactly happened in the Griffith experiment. When the heat killed smooth strain of bacteria was mixed with rough strain of bacteria. So what happened? The genetic material DNA from the smooth strain was present surrounding its cell wall, okay, in the test tube. So the rough strain took the genetic material. As a result, it gets new DNA now. What DNA? The DNA to produce the polysaccharide capsule. So as a result, the rough strain of the bacteria produces capsule around its cell wall. So it became smooth strain now. Since it is having capsule, it is now virulent bacteria. So that's why the smooth strain bacteria kill the mice. Understand? So this is what exactly happened in the Griffith experiment, which was proved by these three scientists. Okay. See, the DNA digested with the DNase enzyme did inhibit the transformation, though it inhibit the transformation because all the DNAs are degraded, digested. But the DNA was directly taken up by this R strain by a process called transformation, which occurs in the bacteria. So by this experiment, they prove that the transforming principle, what exactly Griffith was talking about, is the DNA. Hence, DNA is the genetic material. Okay, this is what these three scientists showed. Whereas these results were not convincing for many biologists during that period of time. Okay, after these experiments also, they were adamant that proteins were the genetic material. They didn't accept these results. Okay, then in the year 1952, two scientists called Hershey and Chase, they did another experiment which proved that DNA is the genetic material, not RNA or proteins. So that we will be seeing in our next lecture. So I hope this lesson is clear for you. If you like this lesson, like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel, Neat Biology Expert. Thank you.